Hi, in the last video, we had a look at the HubSpot to staging process. In this video, what we're going to look at is taking the HubSpot company, I think we called it Template Test Company, that has been newly downloaded, and we're going to take that through into Business Central. Okay, so I'm going to look at the Business Central side of the HubSpot template tasks. So on my browser, I have Business Central open. I've also got HubSpot open still. There's the template test company that we created earlier. Okay, so what we will be doing first is we've got, because there's no upsert capability, we do something where we've got two sets of tasks. They could be rolled into one, but we've got one to handle the create when it's a new company completely. And then after that, we can track it as being a modified company. And the same goes for contacts as well. And the only one that's slightly different is the where we've got a deal one in HubSpot. That goes through as a sales order, and we'll come to that shortly. Okay. So again, just like the HubSpot tasks, the control task will run all of them in sequence. But for testing and just doing demonstrations like this, we can actually run the tasks individually as well. Okay. So what I'm going to do first of all is run the staging to BC companies create, because we can't create a sales order against a company that doesn't exist yet. So what we're going to do is run this task here, and when that runs, it's going to take our template test company and create the company into Business Central and update staging with some IDs that you'll see very, very soon. So I can see it's actually produced a success record, which is always good. So if we have a look, first of all, if I rerun this query, you'll notice that the status will change. And also we should see an ERP ID. So in other words, we'll have the CRM ID from HubSpot, and we'll then have the ERP ID, in this case, from Business Central. Okay. So if I just rerun that query, yep, you can see that a status has been updated to ERP created, and you can see we've now got an ID and a friendly entry there in Business Central. So if I copy that just to make it easier to find in the list there, so I can do, well, I can have a look through the list here, or I can do a filter or a search or something of that nature. So if I do a search here, let me just put the number in there. Yep, you can see there's our template test company. Okay, so if I just open that up, it might take a few seconds on a test server. But you will see the details eventually get populated there. Yep, you can see homepage. We've got some of the address details. Obviously, we can populate a lot more data. These template tasks are exactly that. They're a bit of a starter set of tasks, but you can populate other elements as long as they exist in HubSpot. Okay, so what we'll be doing, that's great because we've now got a company. Okay, if we just take that back, we're going to look at, if we go back another step as well, there we go, we're going to have a look at the sales orders now. Okay, so to do that, we're going to create in HubSpot, we're going to create a deal against that test company. Okay, so what I'm going to do is go up to sales there, go to deals. Okay, and just a little note about deals. Okay, what we have is some exception handling. So if I just have a look at the deals header at the moment. If I just have a look there, okay, we've got a few deals that went in, but there was one deal that we had no lines for. So in the previous video, I mentioned if we get a deal with no lines, then potentially we can't really create it as a sales order into an ERP system. So that will be set as an error with downloaded header, but lines not confirmed. Okay, so that'll get picked up on our error processing in the template task. But you can see we've got a few, well, a couple of other deals that were written to the relevant ERP system. I think one went through to Business Central and one went through to SAP. So what we will do is create a new deal. If I go over to the right there and say create a new deal. Deal name is, I'll put template test with BC for Business Central. The way that HubSpot can be defined, there's many, many ways. I'm using the free version of HubSpot, so you can see I've got to pay if I wanted a different pipeline. But the other thing that we need to do, these are completely configurable, and I'll show you in the configuration table where they need to be set. So for the deal stage, we want to go down and say we've closed it and it's won. I'm just going to put any amount in at the moment, and you'll see that'll get updated by the line shortly. I'll leave the close date in there. I'm just going to say there's no owner at the moment because we haven't added an owner to the company. The deal type is maybe it's new business, and the priority is maybe medium. And then we need to associate this deal with a company, which we will. It's the template test company. There we go. And theoretically, we could have a contact, but we haven't created a contact just yet. Now this is where we have to add a line item. We need to be able to go here and actually add a custom line item, because if you want to manage the product library, in other words, if you want a full catalog of products, then you have to go to the paid version, essentially, as you can see there. So that is not going to help us right now. So what we're going to do is just click create at the moment. It's going to create a deal header, and as you'll see very shortly, it's a bit of a strange setup, possibly, maybe not, but that's created the deal header. Now, if we left it at that, this is where we would have a problem where we would download the header, but it would be in an errored state because we haven't got any lines to be able to create a sales order into an ERP system. So if we just look down on the right-hand side here, you can see we've got line items now. Interestingly, when you create the header, we didn't have this option. It forced us to go and have a product catalog, which means upgrading to the paid version. But we can add custom line items. So if I just add there, we can create a custom line. Again, if we had a product library, great, but we don't. So we're just going to create a custom line item. Now I'm just going to have a quick look at an item or two. In fact, I think I've got it in staging actually. I will just have a look at the deal lines as well. Let's just have a look in the lines, because obviously, if you're going to put a SKU code in to HubSpot, then you have to use essentially an item that exists, and I think that's an item out of Business Central. The others are out of SAP by the looks of things, so I'm going to use that one there. So I won't worry too much about that. I'll go back out there, and I will say this is I think it was a tire or a tube or something like that. But if I put the SKU code in, and this is where I suppose the if you did upgrade and you have a proper product catalog, you could sync products up from your ERP system to HubSpot. But again, right now we don't. This is the template test company line item. There's no images or URL. I'm just going to put a price of $1.99 there. It's a one-time value. It could put a cost in. Things like that, but I don't really want to do that at the moment. It's a one-time cost that will be applied for any of those lines. So whether there's one of them or 10 of them, it'll calculate that correctly. Okay, so if I just click save there. And you can see there it's worked out that we've only got one item. Would you like to update the deal header? So yes. Okay, we can do that. Which I'm just waiting for it to come back, which is brilliant. And you can see if we go back to the deal, you'll see the deal header amount has been updated. But also down in the list on the right, you can see we do have a line item now. So a little bit odd adding the line items like this, but as I say, if you've got the full paid enterprise version or the professional version of HubSpot, then you can have a product library as I've mentioned. Okay. But right now we have a situation where we've got a deal with a line item. So what we can do, first of all, we need to go back to the let's have a look. We need to go back to the HubSpot template because the first thing we need to do is get deals that have been closed, one from HubSpot to staging. So let's run that. While that's running, just a quick note that in the config, again, like we had before with the modified dates, we've got things there. We've got the deal one ID. Okay, now in my instance, it's defaulted to close one, but in other instances, that could be completely different. It can be completely user defined. So that's the value, and the template guide explains how to go and find that in HubSpot. Okay, but that will actually be the stage that it's we're looking for that data. Okay, so I believe the HubSpot side has worked. So let's have a look at the for instance, the deals and the lines. Excuse me. Yep, and I can see there we've got a deal header, which is for that business, the template test company. Okay, and I can see there we've got a line item associated with it. So you can see we've got a line item ID that's come down from HubSpot, but also it's reference to that deal. And you can see there the one ending 1581 is that 1581 header there. Okay, so we've at least got a header and a line. Okay, so we can go back to BPA, and we're looking at Business Central in this example. We've already created the company, and potentially we would have created the contacts. But what we can do now is create the staging deal into Business Central sales order. So let's give that a run. And so this is going to check, are there lines with that deal? If there isn't, you get that error message that I showed earlier. But otherwise, and I can see we've got a successful creation. If we look back in staging, and if I just refresh the header, okay, we can see that the header for the template test company is gone through because the status is now complete. It's not errored. We can see that the deal has been written to the ERP, and I can see also that there's an ERP reference number, which is the order, the internal order, sales order number in Business Central. I can also see that the line item associated has also been inserted. It's got its own line ID, okay, and again the status on the line level is also complete. Deal written to the ERP system. So if we have a look back in Business Central now and just have a look at sales orders. Okay, if we have a look down here, we should see template test company. Yep, and there's a sales order there. So you could see, first of all, right here, the external document number reference is 1581. Okay, so if we look in staging and look back at the deal header, you can see there's the deal ID there, 1581, which is the deal basically out of course, HubSpot. Okay, and you can see the ID. There's probably numerous ways you can look at it, but if you look on the URL there, you can see there's the deal ID there. Okay, 1581. Okay, so that is basically showing the order going through. If we just click into that order. Again, we're just mapping the basic elements. You've got the freedom to map other elements if you need to. But you can see there, it was for the template test company. And you can see there's the external reference document number. And you can see there's the item number there that went through. We had one of those items. In the next video, we're going to go through looking at the same process, but going into SAP Business One.